Puccini pouring from the sky, let's get rich. What? The Gigi finds the sugar dimes, can't quit. What? Now pop the cork and steam the Vega and get lit. What? 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 Introducing Phantom of the Dark, walk through my heaven with levitation from reefers, drenching deep as an E7, showboating with Rugas, flash vines,
Alright folks, welcome to the channel Skins for Life, where we're now in week 8 of the NFL picks. Now, last week I brought to you the upset pick of the year, Jacksonville over Baltimore. Yes. Bow to me. So that's over with. So now we're in a new week. New possibilities. We'll just see what's going on. So let's start with the first matchup of week 8. We have Arizona against Baltimore. I got Baltimore winning this one. They will bounce back. Flacco will have a good game. So everybody that jumped off the bandwagon, they're going to jump back on this week. Yeah, I promise you. They'll jump back on this week. Next matchup. So recap. That was Baltimore over Arizona. Next, we have Minnesota and Carolina. I am now a believer in Cam Newton. Not just because he beat the Redskins last week, just because he is an offensive monster. There's nobody that's been able to stop this cat. Win or lose, he has gotten his game on. So, that being said, Carolina over Minnesota. Minnesota is just too much going on up there. They're back to the whole Love Boat incident type scenario. So, you got McNabb, who pretty much, that was his last game as a starter. That being said, so, next we have Jacksonville versus Houston. Now, I went with Jacksonville last week, rolled the dice, won. Not this week. Houston is going to whoop that ass, and I got Aaron Foster rushing for mad yards. So, fantasy league owners, make sure you start them this week. I got Houston over Jacksonville. So, next we have Miami over New York Giants. Now, who in the hell would put out a tweet saying they're going to knock off the Giants? Not in New York. Dolphins are going to lose badly for some reason. I think it's Brandon Marshall that put that tweet out. But I got the Giants at home, so Giants over the Miami Dolphins. Next, we have New Orleans and St. Louis. That's easy. We're going with the Saints. I don't have to worry about talking about that. Next, we have Indianapolis and Tennessee. Looks like the Colts. I see the future. What do I see? Number one pick, Andrew Luck, going to the Indianapolis Colts. So I'm going to go with Tennessee on this one. Chris Johnson, I thought you was going to get off last week, but apparently you're gimping. So I think Matt Hasselbeck is going to pull Tennessee through. They're beating the Colts. So we have Washington Buffalo. Y'all know the rules. Just like my man Dane said on DR Sports Talk, always go with the Skins. Well, I will always go with the Skins here on Skins for Life, as they will beat Buffalo in Toronto. That's not a lock pick upset. That is actually, they are even teams. I don't care if you laugh. And all those people that hated on my video that I produced like 3 years ago that I made fun of Buffalo, well, y'all may be laughing now, but y'all won't be laughing after this game. Washington over Buffalo. So we have Detroit versus Denver as this thing reloads. Okay, there we go. Detroit's gonna win this game. You know, Tebow is gonna come out. This is his second game starting. I just don't understand the craze with Tebow. He has this thing called, not him, but there's this craze called Tebowing now. It used to be planking. My cousin did it out in LA when he was out there 4th of July weekend. Crazy as he is. Hey, what's up, Danny? But I got definitely Detroit winning this game, so I ain't worried about Tebow. Denver's trash. Detroit all the way. They will bounce back. Next, we have the game of the week. You know, Dallas and Philly fans would like to disagree, but let's just say this is the AFC game of the week. New England versus Pittsburgh. I'm going with Pittsburgh on this one because it's in Pittsburgh. And New England's going to try to spread them out, but Pittsburgh's defense will get to Brady. It'll be all over. Pittsburgh over New England. Now we have Cincinnati versus Seattle. the Bengals. Who they? They 4-2. That's who that. Maybe it's who that. Really, I'm not a Bengals fan, so I don't really care what slogan they use. But I got Cincinnati over the Seahawks. So next, we have Cleveland, San Francisco. 49ers. Then we have the NFC game of the week. Dallas versus Philly. Now, do I got a coin around here? Because I am actually going to choose a coin toss here. But I'll be right back. It's back here. So basically, we're going to go like this. Heads, Cowboys, tails, Eagles. Whoa, didn't really. Yeah, that was a fail. There we go. Eagles. So, by virtue of coin toss, Eagles will win this game. Plus, it's at home. Dallas doesn't have... I'm not going to say Dallas doesn't have a shot, but I see the Eagles winning this game. Then we have the Monday Nighters, San Diego versus Kansas City. Kansas City thinks they're back in the race. A lot of teams in the NFC East think they're back in the race. But out in the AFC West, Raiders are about to slide. Kansas City, the one that did it to them, they crushed them 28-0. But it's San Diego. You're not beating San Diego. I don't care if you're playing in Kansas City. I don't care if you're playing in Oz. San Diego over Kansas City. So no upset picks this week. Thought I'd take a break, let it marinate for a week. And then next week, what I'll do is I'll give you guys 3 upset lock picks for next week. So stay tuned for Skins for Life for next week's picks. 3. Count them. 3. My lucky number 3. Upset lock picks. On behalf of DR Sports Talk, this is DJ81 signing off.